Hey everyone, my name is Andy, and in this tutorial we're going to have a look at the Exploration User Interface, originally developed for the Human Biomolecular Atlas Program, or HubMap, but in this case ported over to the GTEx portal, as you can see here in front of you. Now, the challenge that we are addressing with implementing this user interface, or porting it to the GTEx portal, is that several Common Fund projects, such as GTEx and HubMap, as well as others too, create large molecular and spatial data sets on human tissues. And of course, for this data to be interoperable and reusable, we need to accurately map and compare data from the same organs. Now, GTEx samples are collected across many individuals for the same tissue site using their standard operating procedures, or SOPs, while HubMap samples are collected for fewer individuals but for many specific sites. So, the goal then is to spatially map samples collected under the GTEx SOPs to the so-called HubMap Common Coordinate Framework, to which these HubMap samples are already mapped. So, this exploration user interface that we have here in front of us, or also called the EUI, is a way to semantically and spatially, and also ontologically, explore these data sets in their spatial context and their semantic context. So when you get to the site, you can see that this is all web hosted. You will see that we have the top part here is GTEx, and then here we have the embedded exploration user interface. You will notice that you have this prompt down here that informs you that we log the usage to improve the service. We use this data only to improve the functionality of the interface. You may choose to opt out, or you may click that you understand, and that you understand. You can see that by default, currently in my view here, this interface is dark because I like dark UIs, but you can set it also to the light mode. By default, actually, it's a light mode. So I will demonstrate the light mode here because that's what the default is. So the interface consists of three major parts. We have the left pane here with the filters, we have the 3D stage in the middle, and we have the details pane here on the right. Let's start with how to operate the 3D pane. This is a fully functional 3D window, and if I click and drag my left mouse button here, you can see that I can rotate my virtual camera around this assortment of reference organs here in the middle. If I press and hold my right mouse button, I can pan, so moving the camera sideways. And if I use my mouse scroll wheel or two fingers on the touchpad, if you're using a touchpad on a laptop, you can zoom. Currently, you can see that there's only a small selection of organs turned on by default, but all of these organs up here are available. So for example, we can turn on the large intestine, we can turn on the small intestine. Now you can see it gets a lot fuller in there. Let's go a little over here. We can also turn on the thymus. You can see these numbers here tell you how many tissue blocks are currently registered and available in the exploration user interface in here. Now I'm going to turn off some of these organs just because this is running in a web browser and we want to be respectful of the resources that we are using. So I'm going to turn off the thymus, the spleen, the small intestine also. I'm going to leave the skin on just for reference. We can turn off the large intestine as well. And let's turn off the kidneys here too. So now we only have the heart and the skin left. Now, in many instances, you may not want to see all of the tissue blocks that are available. So we have a set of filters available in the top left here. So if we click on this, we have this flyout. It allows us to choose a sex. Let's maybe go with male. We can define an age range and a BMI range, which I'm just going to leave at their default. We can choose different assay types or filter by different assay types, which is not currently super relevant for GTEx, but it is very relevant for HubMap. And then we can filter by tissue providers. So let's just choose GTEx here and click apply filters. So now we have our male reference body. You can see that we currently have four specific tissue blocks in here. You can see that we have 14 sites total. Okay, so but now what we see here are only four, just for the heart and for the skin. So you can see here skin, one, two, And then there are two more up here. One is in the atrial appendage, the other one is in the left ventricle. So now let's actually look at what we can do with these tissue blocks. So if I click on one of these, for example, on this one, it'll tell me, okay, we have 293 donors currently for this particular site. You can see the mean age here is 56.4 for the males anyway, and the range is 20 to 70 years old. And then click here. You are actually going to open the GTAX portal, okay? And this is going to allow you to look at bulk gene expression and expression QTL data and explore all of that in more detail here on the GTAX portal itself. Now, the interesting part, of course, is when you can compare data for the same site between HapMap and GTAX. So in order to do that, I'm going to go to my filters. I'm just going to reset. Actually, let's just undo this one, click apply filters. So now all of the other data, mostly HapMap data, comes just back in. And now if I zoom in here a little more, we can see that there's actually an overlap between the tissue block for GTAX and the tissue block for HapMap. So now, if I click on the HapMap tissue block, you can see that it is now colored orange. And then I can expand this here, and I can see who from HapMap registered it. And then if you click on this field here, you can inspect the donor information. This is the HapMap portal, just visible here inside of the Exploration User Interface. Close that again. And you can similarly look at tissue block information as well. Notice that you can also open this separately in a new tab by clicking this open and portal link up here. So it is of course interesting to have some more filtering capabilities. So here in the top left we have a body partonomy where we can search for specific anatomical structures. For example, let's search for the septum. You can see that this is a controlled vocabulary. Can click the septum, and now the septum here is highlighted and we can click it, and now we only see the tissue blocks that currently intersect with the septum. We can do that for all of the other anatomical structures in here as well. If I click it again, then the filter disappears. Now likewise, I can do the same thing for cell types, and to make it a little more interesting, let's maybe turn on some of the other organs, also just to present you a little bit of a different view. Here we go. So now in the cell type listing, we can see that, for example, for this cell type here, apocrine cells, we currently have 34 tissue blocks that are predicted to have this particular cell type. And we are predicting this via the anatomical structure cell types plus biomarkers or ASTD plus B table effort that is also part of HapMap. So then if I click this, now we can see that I have the 34 tissue blocks available here in the details pane on the right side, and these are predicted to have these cell types specifically. And then I can click on this again to reset this particular filter. All right, I want to give a little more information about some other elements of the user interface. For example, here in the top right, we have the circular arrow button that allows you to reset the view. It can be challenging sometimes navigating 3D spaces on 2D screens. That's why we included this. You can also click on this link up here and get to the CCF portal, where you can read up about the Common Coordinate Framework effort that is part of HapMap. We also, on the top right here, have an info button, where when you click it, you get access to demo materials, some about information, information about HapMap itself, information about the Common Coordinate Framework, or CCF, as we discussed before, with the same CCF portal link that you have up here, and finally, acknowledgements. One more thing that I would like to show that is kind of cool to look at is concerns the details pane over here. For this, I'm going to hone in on a skin tissue block. Let's go, for example, to this one back here on the back of the right arm. I'm gonna click on this. And then we can see again, this is a HapMap tissue block. And this now shows us the number of tissue sections that are in this particular tissue block. This should help you explore all of the data that is cross-mapped here between GTEx and HubMap in a little more detail. Now let's zoom out and admire these human bodies here again in their full beauty. So in this tutorial, we investigated the exploration user interface embedded in the GTEx portal. We hope that this helps you to cross-compare data from GTEx and HubMap while they're all being mapped into the same spatial, semantic, and ontological space. Thank you very much.